Yeah, no, the project is a project that is implemented by three partners, Ecoche Sharia, Apexmesh, and Sechef International. The objective of this project is to see that the communities living within informal settlements, they're not influenced or manipulated by politicians to cause conflict to them. Their areas. It targets communities living in informal settlements,
okay.
Kibera, Madare, Korogocho, and Kiambiu.
Okay.
When we are doing the devolution festival, one of the issues that was coming out strongly is that the young people have a noble role to play in the community and to promote peace. And devolution being a component of governance in Kenya, it was important that the youth are invited. Devolution, because if devolution hasn't been effectively devolved as proposed in the constitution, then it becomes an avenue for conflict, and that's why you are now engaging young people to understand what devolution is. You're one of the winners of the devolution award radio talk show.
Okay. I saw this question through Getty Radio, and I participated in it. I answered it, and I received a call from Ecoche Sharia.
What was the question?
The question was about how a governor can be impeached.
What was your feedback?
My feedback was that the members of the MCS, members of county assemblies, should sit down. They should debate on the particular governor of that county. And after that, the speaker of the county assembly should forward that name to the... If the governor is impeached to the county level, should forward that name to the speaker, should notify the speaker of the Senate, so that the speaker of the Senate should convene a special sitting so that the Senate can discuss and debate. That's the process.
That's good. You've seen the governor for Embu County has been impeached, and with respect to your understanding of the constitution, especially on devolution, do you think the process was fair?
You know, there was a court order and process. The governor went to the lawyer court, went to other court. So I think that they could have waited for that court order. After that, they could have proceeded.
Well, having known devolution, as I can see, do you think that this process is something that we should explore more? And do you think, or do you propose that we should reach a wider youth program in terms of then being, in terms of creating awareness to this young people? Because devolution has become an issue in governance.
Many people in this country, they even don't understand the issue. They don't know the process, they don't know what the vision is about. Many of them, if you ask now with the slaps, if you go to Mandela, maybe where I come from, they just don't know, they just know that. They don't know if it's lost, they don't know. Now, with a program like this, will help people and it enlightens them to understand more and fight for their rights.
Apart from the devolution talk shows, what strategies do you recommend for this program to reach, let's say, those people that you're talking about, let's say, in Mandela? Despite the fact that the project doesn't target communities outside Nairobi, what do you recommend for people who live in Mandera but can still get the information?
People living in Mandera, there is a radio station, even in Slim. If you cannot go there or create an office there, you can use that radio station. It is a community, it is in Wadia, Dariza, it is a northeastern province, the former northeastern province.
What is the name of the radio station? The station is Slim.
The head office is Slim. So you can use that one and you can mobilize for it.
How was the experience in answering this question?
The experience was very good.
You liked it?
I liked it, I enjoyed it.
Oh, good. So we wish you the very best. We'll be engaging you maybe in future Hawaii program. And I will be glad that at least when you're going home, read the constitution, understand the provision of the constitution, share it with your colleagues,
okay.
And welcome any critique.
Okay,
congratulations and all the best.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so much. One of the issues that was coming out strongly is that during election, the young people are being used to champion or to propagate violence simply because the politicians are manipulating them majorly so that they can participate in the conflict. So the main objective of this is to understand that we've been having devolution peace as an element to empower young people to understand the parameters, the principle of devolution, how devolution works, and the structure. Because if devolution hasn't been effectively implemented, then it becomes an avenue to create conflict again. So you've been one of those people who participated in the devolution. Please, can you tell us your name and your experience about the entire process?
We don't want this to be used again, like what you saw in 2007. 2007 was so bad. where people ride on handouts. A person giving you 100 shillings, then you go and burn a house or someone, or you go and kill someone, your neighbor. So I think the initiative was very powerful, and I'm so happy. That's why I even participated in that. I live in a home settlement. I have experience. I'm with those people every day. When you are in home settlement, the life there is so good. Mugging, all the daytime mugging. When you see at night, it is staggering. It's so bad. This is a separate due to unemployment. You find that when people are given the money, when a politician gives you money, he finishes with you. There's nothing he will do for you after giving you money, because they are giving money to get what they want. After getting elected, then it's nothing. Your life remains the same. I think this is why the rates of crime in the former settlement has risen in the past, because youths are unemployed. Unemployment is the real cause of the rate of murdering and gathering in the former settlement. So, as youths, with the establishment of the Kituo cha Sheria, we should come up with initiatives like the one that they say, which is so good, so that we can sensitize those people.
Tunajaribu kuelimisha jamii. Soa jamii ambayo ina changamoto za kimaisha kule kutoka kiguduni. Sasa hatuwezi kubali kupewa pesa ya kuleta propaganda. Ama hatuwezi kupewa pesa, hatuwezi kubali kuchukua pesa ambayo italeta chuki ama italeta shida katika serikali. Sisi tunachukua pesa ya kuhamasisha jamii kuhusu haki zao.
Na pia naweza hamasisha watu watembee kwa hizo jiji, because si kila mtu ana simu anaweza Facebook. Ni vizuri wakitembea kutoa ndana kaa kwa nyumba tu hivyo bila kazi. Kwa hamasisha pia.
Shukran boss.